Okay. And today what we are going to studying means lanthanide elements. Lanthanide series elements, what is oxidation states, electronic configuration they will exhibit, what oxidation state they're exhibiting, and what is mean by here lanthanide contraction, and what are the chemical reactions of your lanthanide series elements. So today we are going to seeing that lanthanide series elements we are going to see. And tomorrow class, we are going to see that actinoids, only small concept will be left, right? Today, we will see that only that lanthanide series elements and all, what is electronic configuration? What are the major periodic trends are exhibiting? What types of compounds is forming there? So that and all, today class, we are going to see that. So I will share the screen, all of you wants to see that. Right. I'll display the screen. All of you just go through it. So already yesterday we have seen that. Transition elements on yesterday class we have seen that. So today we are going to see that lanthanide series elements. What is lanthanide series elements are presenting there? What are the oxidation states they exhibiting? Next, what is the electronic configuration they will show us, and general characteristics of your lanthanide series elements, we are going to see that, right? So tomorrow class, we are going to see that the actinoid series, right? Only a very small concept will be left. So that one tomorrow class, we will see that. So first one, see that lanthanide series elements. So lanthanide series elements is nothing but lanthanide series elements is nothing but F block element, first row elements, right? For example, looking like this. So this is called lanthanide series. First series, first row elements, what you call mean lanthanide series. And second row elements are called as actinoid series, we are calling them. So now first one, we are going to see that lanthanide series elements under, we are going to see there. So lanthanoid series as well as actinoid series, each row, how many elements are presenting means totally 14 elements are presenting there. So lanthanoid series as well as actinoid series, totally how many elements are existing means 14 elements is presenting there in each row. So lanthanoid is 14 elements are there, and actinoid also 14 elements are presenting there. So let us see that first one, lanthanide series elements, what are the electronic configurations they will exhibit, right? So first one, see that electronic configuration, lanthanide series elements, electronic configuration, let us see that. It may be noted that atoms of these elements have electronic configuration with 6s2 common, but with the variable occupancy of 4F level, however, the electronic configuration of all the tri-positive ions are of the form 4FN. So that means F is, N is nothing but here 1 to 14 electrons is presenting with increasing atomic number. So that means these transition elements, that means lanthanide series elements, common, what is electronic configuration is presenting means 6s2 is the common electronic configuration is present. And these lanthanide series elements are tri-positive. Tri-positive is nothing but what you are saying means 3+ oxidation state commonly. 3+, right? So that means if you are taken here 3D series elements, you are taken means what electronic configuration? +2 is the common oxidation state, right? Same like if you are taken here lanthanide series elements, you are taken means, so their oxidation state is here 3+ oxidation state commonly these elements are exhibiting. So therefore that oxidation state, what you call mean tri-positive ions and all, mostly these lanthanide series elements will be exhibiting. So this f orbital totally how many electrons is present in means f orbital here 1 to 14 electrons will be present in there. So f orbital totally how many subshells will be there means 7 subshells will be present in there, looking like this. So d orbital means only 5 will be there. So f orbital means totally how many will be there means 7 will be present in there, right? So each shell how many electrons here occupying means 2 electrons will be occupying this takes place. Therefore, totally how many electrons is occupying in a f orbital means 14 electrons totally. So each shell 2 electrons. So 7 subshells are there. So 7 2s are 14. So that means f orbital how many maximum electrons is accommodating means 1 to 14 electrons will be presenting there. Right. So this is about your electronic configuration of lanthanide series. So lanthanide series common electronic configuration what will be 6s2 will be commonly is present, and 4f orbital what happened means 1 to 14 electrons will be presenting there, right? And this lanthanide series element what is the oxidation state they will exhibit means all the lanthanide series they will exhibit plus 3 oxidation state and all they will exhibit plus 3 tri positive ions they will exhibit with increasing their atomic number. So atomic number is increasing there as well as so they will exhibit tri-positive ions and all mostly these elements are forming. Next one, see that. So atomic and ionic size is what happened. So atomic size or ionic size for lanthanide series, what will happen? So let us see that. The overall decrease in atomic and ionic radii from lanthanum to lutetium is unique feature in the chemistry of the lanthanides. So that means overall decreasing of atomic and ionic radii. So lanthanide series we are taken means atomic as well as ionic radius what happened means overallly, it will be decreasing is takes place. Decreasing is nothing but what you are saying means gradually what happened, atomic size will be decreasing there. So just look at here once your diagram, all of you ones. Starting element, what you are saying means lanthanum is there. So ending element, what you call me lutetium. So lanthanum to lutetium, you are coming down like this. We are seeing means graph and all what happened, falling is takes place. So atomic number, what happened? Atomic number should be increasing is takes place. 57, 59, 61, 63, up to 71, like that increasing is takes place. Atomic number is increasing there, but atomic size and all, atomic and ionic size and all, what happened means, so gradually it will be decreasing is takes place. So the gradual decreasing of atomic size for these elements is called as lanthanoid contraction. Lanthanoid contraction, like that we are calling there. So already I told you that all the lanthanide series elements, what is a common oxidation state they will exhibit means tri-positive ion, tri-positive nature. So tri-positive is nothing but all these transition lanthanide series elements, they will contain charge here, plus 3 will be presenting there. Lanthanum, cerium, prosodium, neodymium, promethium, samarium, europium, gadolinium, terbium, dubnium, hafnium. So all these elements and all, what is the oxidation state they will exhibit mean tri-positive. That means plus 3 oxidation state these elements will be exhibiting. So now let us see that what is mean by here lanthanoid contraction. So lanthanide contraction is nothing but so the gradual decreasing of atomic and ionic radii from lanthanum to lutetium is called lanthanoid contraction. From lanthanum to lutetium you are moving means atomic size or ionic radii what happened means decreasing is takes place. So the gradual decreasing of atomic and ionic radii is called as lanthanoid contraction. Lanthanoid contraction like that we are calling there, right? So this is very, very important. So what is lanthanide contraction? What are the major causes will be there? Why it is lanthanide contraction will be happening there? What are the major consequences will be presenting for this lanthanide contraction? So this, they ask, mute yourself, somebody noise will comes there. Mute yourself, right. Next one, see that. So that means the gradual decreasing of atomic and ionic radii from lanthanum to lutetium is called as lanthanoid contraction. So let us see that. So it has a far-reaching consequences in chemistry of the third transition series of the elements. The decreasing in atomic radii is not quite regular as it regular in M3 plus ions. This contraction is of course similar to that observed in the ordinary transition series and is attributed to the same cause, the imperfect shielding of one by another in the same subshell. However, the shielding of one 4F electron by another is less than one D electron by another with the increasing of nuclear charge along the series. There is fairly regular decrease in the sizes with increasing atomic number. So simply lanthanide contraction, why? What is the causes will be takes place? What is the major consequences is presenting means? Why lanthanide contraction will be happening for 3D series elements like scandium to up to zinc? That series, 3D series as well as 4D series elements also, they will affecting for this lanthanide contraction. Already I told you, I think this point also, lanthanide contraction, why it is causes means, due to presence of poor shielding effect of 4F electrons, poor shielding effect of 4F orbital or 4F electrons. Or else we can say that imperfect shielding of 4F orbital is called as lanthanide contraction. So that means 4F orbitals are what happened means poor shielding effect it will be part undergoing this takes place. So because of your poor shielding effect, 4F electrons are what happened means here. So increasing their atomic number as well as effective nuclear charge also increasing is takes place. So due to this poor shielding effect of 4F orbitals, atomic radii what happened means gradually decreasing is takes place. So due to imperfect shielding of 4F electrons, so effective nuclear charge will be increasing there and atomic size is what happened gradually decreasing is takes place. So this is because of this poor shielding effect of 4F electrons, atomic and ionic radii will be gradually decreases. That is a major consequences, right? What is the reason is behind me? This is the reason. So atomic number is gradually increasing there. So effective nuclear charge, what happened means effective nuclear charge is also more will be increasing there. So effective nuclear charge increasing means 4F electrons are what happened, poor shielding effect they are undergoing. So they are less attraction of electrons is takes place. So because of this less attraction of electrons from the nucleus and outermost shell, so the atomic size is gradually here decreasing is takes place one by one. So that's why what happened means, if you are moving from one element to another element, from lanthanum to cerium, cerium to prosodium, prosodium to neodymium, next to promethium like that. For each and every element, one element after another element, what happened means atomic size is very, very gradually what happened, decreasing is takes place due to imperfect shielding of 4F orbitals. Due to imperfect shielding of 4F electrons, effective nuclear charge will be increasing with increasing their atomic number. So each and every one element after another element, what happened means gradually their atomic radii will be gradually decreasing is takes place. So due to presence of your lanthanide contraction, atomic or ionic radii, what happened means decreasing is takes place. Next one, see there. Next one, see this next paragraph. The cumulative effect of the contraction of the lanthanide series is known as lanthanoid contraction. So that means contraction is nothing but what happened means size and all, whatever, for example, big balloon is there. Hello, balloon inside, what happened? Air you are blowed means size will be very bigger, will be presenting there. So slowly air and all, it will be leakage is happening. So balloon size, what happened, gradually decreasing is takes place, right? Slowly, for example, a small pinhole you are put it for the balloon. So what happens, size and all gradually here decreasing is takes place. So that means larger size of the balloon, what happens, small pinhole you are put it means. So the gradually what happens, size will be gradually decreasing is takes place. Here, why these lanthanide series elements atomic radius will be decreases means due to presence of your lanthanide contraction. So due to imperfect shielding of 4F electrons, atomic radius will be gradually decreasing is takes place. That is called as lanthanide contraction. This is important definition. Due to imperfect shielding of 4F electrons from lanthanum to lutetium, atomic radius will be decreases. It is called lanthanoid contraction. Next one, see that. Causes the radii of the members of the third transition series to be very similar to those of the corresponding members of the second series. The almost identical radii of zirconium and hafnium, a consequence of lanthanide contraction, account for their occurrence together in nature and for the difficulty faced in their separation. If you are taking a zirconium, you are taking zirconium and here hafnium. So zirconium and hafnium, these two elements, what happened means they will exhibit similar atomic radii will be presenting, the identical atomic radii will be presenting there. So that means zirconium you are taken means 160 picometer is there. That means atomic radius how much is there? 160 picometer. Hafnium you are taken. Hafnium is 159 picometer is presenting there. 159. So that means these two elements are what happened means identical radii will be presenting there. Identical atomic radii will be presenting there. But these two elements separation and all what happened means we cannot able to separate by using physical methods. So that means generally these two elements separation will be very difficulty by using physical methods. You have to apply some chemical methods, then only we can easily separating from zirconium and hafnium elements. But atomic radius, what happened? Both are here nearly same, only presenting there. Only one digit only here differ. But we cannot able to separating physical methods. By using physical methods, zirconium and hafnium elements, we cannot able to separate. By using some chemical methods only, we are going to separating this takes place. So due to because of your lanthanide contraction, we cannot able to separate easily. Hafnium and zirconium. So this is the explanation for this second paragraph. So this is overly lanthanide contraction. So simple words only you have to remember. So they will ask in question like, what define lanthanide contraction and write its major consequences. Like that they will ask him. So lanthanide contraction is nothing but due to poor shielding effect of 4F electrons, lanthanum to lutetium atomic size will be gradually decreasing is takes place. So the gradual decreasing of atomic radii is called lanthanide contraction. So due to because of this lanthanide contraction, what happens? 3D series elements and 4D series elements, their atomic radius will be gradually decreasing is takes place. So 3D series elements as well as 4D series elements, atomic radius will be gradually decreasing is takes place. So for each and every element, what happened? Atomic number is increasing there. Atomic radius is what happened, mean gradually decreasing is takes place. From one element to another element, if you are moving, means gradual decreasing of atomic radius is takes place. So due to here, poor shielding effect of 4F electrons, atomic nuclear atomic size is gradually decreases with the increasing effective nuclear charge. So can you able to separate this lanthanide series elements easily? Means mostly we cannot able to separate similar radii containing elements also. I think the best example, hafnium and another one is zirconium. So hafnium and zirconium elements are both are nearly quite atomic radii will be presenting there. So hafnium is containing 159 picometer will be presenting, and zirconium is containing 160 picometer is presenting there. Can you able to separate these two elements by using physical method? Means we cannot able to separate. It is very difficult to separating is takes place. So why we cannot able to separate easily while identical radii of these two elements? Means due to because of your lanthanide contraction, we cannot able to separate by using physical methods. You have to apply some chemical methods, then only we can able to separate. So this is about here atomic and ionic radii of lanthanide series elements, right? So simple definition is there, just to see the reason, consequences, what is the major consequence, what is the major cause mean, this is the cause. The imperfect shielding of one electron by another in the same subshell. However, the shielding of one 4F electrons are having less than the one D electron by another in the, with the increasing the nuclear charge along the series. Simple. Due to imperfect shielding of 4F electrons, effective nuclear charge is increasing there, and atomic number also increasing, but atomic radius what happened gradually decreasing is takes place. So this is called as lanthanide contraction. So this is major cause. What is the reason means? So due to because of 4F, poor shielding effect of 4F electrons. Are the major cause. So because of this consequence, what is the major consequences will be there? Mean because of this, we cannot able to separate here lanthanide series elements easily. By using here chemical methods only, we are going to separating there. And due to because of this lanthanide contraction, some elements like 3D series elements and 4D series elements, they will exhibit quietly the similar atomic radius they will exhibit. That means gradual decreasing of their atomic radius will be takes place. So this is a major consequences for that. Next one, see that. So what are the major oxidation states these elements and all they will exhibit? What are the major oxidation states these elements and the lanthanide series elements and all they will exhibit? Let us see that. lanthanide series elements, what are the major oxidation states they will exhibit? Just look at here, all of you ones. This paragraph, all of you ones see there. Yes. In the lanthanides, lanthanum 2 and lanthanum 3 compounds are predominant species. So that means either we can express like La, lanthanum 2, La plus 2 also we can express in there, or else we can express like Ln 3 plus also we can express in there. That means lanthanum how we are expressing means either plus 2 also we can express in there, and plus 3 also mostly they will exhibit. That means mostly these lanthanum series element they will exhibit a plus 3 oxidation state only they will exhibit, right? Lanthanum series element mostly what happen means plus 3 oxidation state these elements now they will exhibit. Sometime it will show here plus 2 oxidation state also they will exhibit sometime. So that means only few element they will exhibit plus 2 and all they will exhibit. But a common oxidation state for lanthanide series elements is plus 3 oxidation state they will exhibit, right? So predominantly this lanthanide series elements, what is oxidation state they will exhibit means lanthanum 2 also they will exhibit, and a lanthanum Ln 3 also they will exhibit. So these two oxidation states are predominant. Predominant is nothing but major oxidation states exhibiting by the lanthanide series elements. Right. However, occasionally it will show here plus 2 and plus 4 ions in solution or in solid compounds are also obtained. So just now I told you that lanthanum is showing a plus 2 oxidation state is exhibiting, and common oxidation state what you're saying plus 3 oxidation state. And in case of your ionic solution formation or solid compound formation, lanthanide series element they will exhibit plus 2 oxidation state as well as plus 4 oxidation state also it will exhibit. So what form, what phase it is exhibiting means, so either it is exhibiting like ionic solution formation or else solid compound formation, they will exhibit plus 2 and plus 4 oxidation states they will exhibit. Next one, see there. This irregularity arises mainly from the extra stability of empty half filled or filled F subshell. So why these lanthanide series and all they will exhibit like plus 2 oxidation state, plus 4 oxidation state and plus 3 oxidation state. So irregularity of your oxidation state, why these elements are showing means due to presence of extra stability for empty orbitals, empty orbitals as well as half-filled orbitals, and another one is full-filled orbitals. So due to because of here either empty orbitals and half-filled orbitals are completely full-filled orbitals, 4F series elements they will exhibit irregular oxidation states. That means plus 2 they will exhibit, plus 4 is the exhibiting, plus 3 also they will exhibit. For example, if you are taken like a transition elements, you are if you are taken your P block elements, you are taken. So 13th group elements all are here, plus 3 oxidation state they will exhibit. 14th group element, plus 4 oxidation state. 15th group elements, they will show here minus minus 3 oxidation state like that. That means mostly they will exhibit 1 or 2 oxidation state only they will exhibit. But these element, lanthanide series elements, what happen means they will exhibit more than 1 oxidation state they will exhibit. Right. Plus 2, plus 4, plus 3, like the different oxidation states and all they will exhibit. Why they are showing here different oxidation states? Why it will be arises means due to presence of completely filled electrons, 4f electrons, as well as half filled electronic configuration of 4f subshell. So because of these two reasons, lanthanide series elements, they will exhibit irregular oxidation states. So simple reason. So irregularity, different oxidation state these elements are exhibiting means extra stability of empty off filled or full filled subshell. So because of these electronic configurations, lanthanide series elements, they will exhibit irregular oxidation states, mostly they will exhibit. Thus, the formation of cerium 4, Ce4, that means cerium 4, is favored by its noble gas configuration. So cerium element, while exhibiting plus 4 oxidation state, means it will attain noble gas electronic configuration. Noble gas electronic configuration it will exhibit. Right. But it is a strong oxidant reverting to the common oxidation state plus 3. But the cerium element, what happened means it is acting like a good strong oxidizing agent. So strong oxidizing nature, when it will exhibit means cerium plus 3 oxidation state will be presenting means it will shows strong oxidizing nature they will exhibiting. But cerium and all, when it is stable means cerium plus 4 oxidation state means they will exhibit noble gas electronic configuration it will exhibiting there. In plus 3 oxidation state, it is acting like good oxidizer, strong oxidant like that, it will be acting is takes place. Oxidizing agent like that, it will be working is takes place. So the E naught value for cerium 4 and cerium 3 plus is plus 1.74 volt, which suggests that it can oxidize water. So cerium 4 plus and cerium 3 plus, what is the E naught standard electrode value is exhibiting means plus 1.74 volts energy will be exhibiting. So which suggests that it can oxidize water. So cerium and all, what happen easily, it will be oxidizing water molecule. Water molecule and all, very easily it will be oxidizing is takes place. And the cerium plus 4 where we are using means especially for analytical reagent. Analytical reagent purpose, especially we are using the good analytical reagent purpose we are using there. Already they given, just see that. Cerium 4 is good analytical reagent we are using. Promodium, neodymium, terbium, dubnium also exhibit plus 4 oxidation state, but only in oxides. So oxide formation, what happened means, so promodium, neodymium, next terbium and dysprosium, these elements are all exhibiting plus 4 oxidation state. Plus 4 oxidation state they will exhibit. When these elements are all, they will exhibit plus 4 oxidation state means in presence of your oxides, oxide formation only they will exhibit plus 4 oxidation state they will exhibit. Right. Next one, see that. So uranium 2 plus is also formed by losing 2 s electrons, and its F7 configuration account for the formation of this ion. However, uranium 2 plus is also acting like a strong reducing agent, charging to the common oxidation state plus 3. So uranium plus 2 also is acting like a strong oxidizing reducing agent, it will be acting there. But when it will be stable oxidation state, where it is stable means plus 3 oxidation state, this case only what happened means it is more stable in nature. Uranium is also exhibiting plus 3 oxidation state. But here plus 2 oxidation state, uranium is acting like a good reducing agent. Right. So similarly, erbium YB, erbium 2 plus, which has for a 14 configuration, a 14 configuration is a reductant, is a reductant. That means erbium 2 plus is at a 4F configuration, they acting like a good reducing agent. A reducing agent. This 4F14 is nothing but what happened? Completely full electronic configuration is presenting there. So this case, erbium, it will show a plus 2 oxidation state, it will exhibit. So this plus 2 oxidation state means they acting like a good reducing agent. So that means here what you are discussing in this paragraph means in that lanthanide series elements, what are the oxidation states they will exhibit? So over element, different oxidation states they will exhibit. So some cases what happen, it will be more stable. Off-field electronic configuration is attaining, or else completely full electronic configuration is attaining, this takes place. So some cases lower oxidation state will be existing, but it is having good oxidizing nature as well as reducing nature they will exhibiting. So next one, see that. Next one is terbium, TB. TB4 is also having half-filled F orbitals and is a oxidizer oxidant. The behavior of samarium is very much like europium, exhibiting both plus 2 and plus 3 oxidation state. So simply what you are saying means, in mind oxidation states for lanthanide series, what you are finally concluding means, so lanthanide series element, they will exhibit oxidation state plus 2, plus 3, and plus 4 is exhibiting there. So what is the common oxidation state for these lanthanide series elements means, plus 3 is the common oxidation state for this lanthanide series. In case of your aqueous solution, like it will be aqueous state, like ionic solution formation or else solid formation, they will exhibit plus 2 and plus 4 oxidation state they will exhibit. So mostly all lanthanide series element, they will exhibit oxidation state is plus 3 they will exhibit. Why these elements under irregular oxidation states is exhibiting means, so due to presence of half field electronic configuration, next completely filled electronic configuration, complete filled electronic configuration, mostly these lanthanide series elements, they will exhibit irregular oxidation state they will exhibiting, right? So some elements under they acting like a more strong oxidizing agent as well as strong reducing agent is takes place. But as when it is stable means either half field electronic configuration or full field electronic configuration and all, mostly these elements and all highly stable in nature. So this is about here oxidation states of lanthanide series elements. And next one see that tabular column is given, electronic configurations for these elements symbol is given. Just you have to learn about these elements, what are the element names and symbols, and you have to learn, no need to remember that electronic configurations, all these things. So namakku theva illa edhume. Maximum we have to use these symbols and elements on especially very very important. So lanthanum, what is the symbol means? La. Cerium, Ce. Prosodium, Pr. Neodymium, Nd. Promethium, Pm. Samarium, Sm. Europium, Eu. Gadolinium, Gd. Terbium, Tb. Disopium, Dy. Polium, HO. Erbium, ER. Thorium, TM. Yttrium, YB. Lutetium, LU. So these elements, names as well as symbols, and all, everyone must and should be hard to remember. So electronic configuration, this and all very difficult to keeping in mind. This 4F electronic configuration, common electronic configuration and all you are remembering there. Right. So remaining and all, this and all no need to remember. Common electronic configuration for F orbital, that one you have to remember, that is enough. Right. So this is for lanthanide series elements. Next one, general characteristics. Only we will conclude up to this general characteristics. So tomorrow class we are going to seeing that lanthanide actinide series and all we are going to seeing that. So just only this general characteristics for lanthanide series we will conclude. Just look at here all of you. All the lanthanides are silvery white soft metals and tarnish rapidly in air. The hardness increases with increasing atomic number. So atomic number increasing means hardness of these metals also increasing is takes place. And mostly these lanthanide series elements are silvery white soft metals. Silvery white soft metals. With increasing atomic number, automatically hardness of these metals also increasing. Samarium is being steel hard. Samarium element, what happens? Steel hard. Their melting points range is 1000 to up to 1200 Kelvin. But samarium melts at 1623 Kelvin. So samarium element, what happened means? Samarium element, its melting points is here 1000 to up to here 1200 Kelvin temperature only it will be melting is takes melting point. But it is a boiling point, how much will be presenting? Melting point, so much is presenting means. It will be rises from, so 1623 Kelvin temperature it is, melting is takes place. They have typical metallic structure and are good conductors of heat and electricity. So mostly these lanthanide series elements also acting like good oxidizer, good electricity, good conductor of your heat and electricity. Heat and electricity and all their passing is takes place. And a density and the some other properties change smoothly. So density is another density and all what happens smoothly it will be changing is takes place. One element to another element, density and all what happen it will be density and other properties also differing is takes place. But europium and erbium, so occasionally samarium and samarium and thorium. So these two elements and all, these four elements and all, some exceptional cases there. Europium and erbium, next samarium and thorium. So these four elements and all, what happen? Exceptional case they will exhibit density as well as remaining other properties and all. These four elements will be exhibiting different properties compared to that lanthanide series elements. Next one, see that. Many trivalent lanthanide ions are colored. So mostly all the lanthanide ions are what happened? Colored ions, both in the solid phase and in the aqueous solution. So solid phase or else your aqueous solutions, mostly these lanthanide series elements are colored trivalent ion. That means trivalent is nothing but here plus 3 oxidation state they will exhibit. So plus 3 oxidation state exhibiting all the lanthanide series elements are colored in nature, solid phase as well as aqueous solutions. That means lanthanide series are what happened mean colored ions and all they're exhibiting. What phase they will exhibit colored ions means either in aqueous phase or in solid phase, lanthanide series elements are colored ions they are exhibiting. Next one, see there. Color of these ions may be attributed to the presence of 4F electrons. Due to because of your 4F electrons, what happened means 4F electrons. Lanthanide series elements are here colored ions they are exhibiting. Colored ions, coloring, colored ions and all they are exhibiting this takes place. Neither lanthanum nor lutetium 3+ ion shows any color. but the rest do so. So lanthanum 3 plus and lutetium 3 plus. So these two elements and all, what happened? So neither lanthanum 3 plus nor lutetium 2 plus ion shows any color. Any color they will show. And rest of the elements and all, what happened? They won't show any color. However, absorption bands are narrow, probably because of the excitation within 4F level. So why these lanthanum series elements and all, they're exhibiting colored ions means, due to excitation of your 4F electrons in the same shells, they will exhibit here different colored ions and all they're exhibiting. Nothing is there. So because of your excitation of electrons in the F orbital, looking like this. So F subshell is there. Totally 7 boxes will be present like that, right? So here one electron will be exciting, will be takes place into another shell. That means within the same shell level only what happened means electrons will be exciting, this takes place. So due to excitation of like this manner, electrons what happened means these elements and all, they're exhibiting mostly colored ions and all, they're exhibiting this takes place. Different colored and all, they're exhibiting this takes place. That one they're taken. So due to excitation of the same within a F level, just look at here. Because of the excitation within F level, so they will exhibit here different colored ions and all they're exhibiting. The lanthanide ions other than the 4F0 type, that means lanthanum and cerium 4 plus, and the F14 type, erbium and lutetium, are all paramagnetic. The paramagnetism arises due to maximum in neodymium element. So neodymium element and all what happened means maximum they will exhibit paramagnetism and all they will exhibit. Here which elements and all they shows here paramagnetic character means F0, that means F0 type elements, and F14 elements and all they will exhibit here paramagnetic character they will exhibit. Right, actually what you are saying, paramagnetic character is nothing but unpaired electrons must be required. That compounds only they will exhibit paramagnetism. But in F orbital what happened means 4F0 configuration, 4F0 configuration or 4F14 electronic configuration containing elements are exhibiting paramagnetic character they are exhibiting. Paramagnetic character they are exhibiting here. So especially here maximum paramagnetic character which element will be exhibiting means neodymium. So neodymium element maximum paramagnetic character they are exhibiting. The first ionization enthalpy of the lanthanides are around 600 kilojoule per mole, and second ionization energy if you are taken means 1200 kilojoule mole inverse. Comparable with those of calcium, a detailed discussion of the variation of the third ionization enthalpy indicates that exchange enthalpy consideration. So as in the 3D orbital of the first transition elements. So that means if you take in here first ionization energy for this lanthanide series, how much is there means first ionization energy is 600 kilojoule per mole is there. Second ionization energy, how much is there means it will show here 1200 kilojoule per mole is there. If you take in third ionization energy means what happened means very much higher value will be exhibiting this takes place, right? So what is indicating here means, so energy and all what happened means here more and more energy will be required to remove the electrons for this transition lanthanide series elements. So why means due to because of your extra stability purpose, what happened means, so more and more maximum how many electrons here losing is takes place for this F block elements means 3 electrons here losing is takes place. So while losing here 3 electrons, what happened means either they will attain a stable empty orbitals will be forming, or off-field configuration they will attain, or else completely filled orbital electronic configuration they will exhibit. So for this case, ionization enthalpy values, what happened means very much higher will be presenting there compared to first ionization energy and second ionization energy. Third ionization energy and all, what happened means more and more amount of energy will be required. So due to because of to attaining either half field electronic configuration or completely full field electronic configuration, these lanthanide series elements, they will lose up to 3 electrons here, losing is takes place. So just look at here, while 3 electrons is gaining means what will happen? So 3 electrons here, lanthanide series elements are gaining means what will happen? Let us see this. Ln 3 plus while gaining 3 electrons. So what happened mean to become Ln, lanthanum will be forming there. Right. So this Ln and L, what happened means quietly they will exhibit calcium behavior. Calcium element, how they will exhibit properties, same properties and all these lanthanum also they will exhibiting this takes place. So this is about here chemical general characteristics of your lanthanide series elements. So just this point alone, just remember that remaining nothing is there, this explanation part. Just this diagram and all of you want to see there. Chemical reactions. What are the major chemical reactions of this lanthanide series element? So lanthanum series element, all lanthanide series element while react with the acids means hydrogen gas will be producing there. All lanthanide series elements while react with the acid means hydrogen gas will be producing. Lanthanum series elements while react while burning in presence of oxygen means to form lanthanoid oxide. Lanthanum oxide LN2O3 will be forming. Lanthanum oxide will be forming there. That means lanthanum series, if you are burning in presence of oxygen means lanthanum oxide will be forming. Lanthanum series elements while burning with the sulfur means to form lanthanum sulfide will be forming there. Lanthanum series element while react with the nitrogen, if you are burning means lanthanides will be forming. Lanthanum nitrides will be forming there. Lanthanum series elements while burning with the carbon means lanthanum carbide will be forming there. Lanthanum series element while react with water molecule means lanthanum hydroxide and hydrogen gas will be producing. Lanthanum series elements while react with the halogens means lanthanum halides will be forming there. You should write like this manner, easy chemical reactions. So they will ask, write the chemical reactions for lanthanum series elements. Like that they asking means, so simply how to draw this diagram looking like this. Oxygen if you are burning in lanthanum oxide, sulfur if you are burning in lanthanum sulfide, nitrogen you are burning in lanthanum nitride, carbon if you are burning in lanthanum carbide, water you are treated in lanthanum hydroxide, halogen we are treated in lanthanum halides, acid you are reacting in hydrogen gas is producing there. So these are the mostly here chemical reactions of your lanthanide series elements. So this is a very, very important this formation also. What are the major chemical reactions of lanthanide series means? You must supposed to write this diagram under. Diagram under we are supposed to writing for this. Right. And mostly these lanthanide series elements where you are using. What purpose you are using this lanthanide series elements means? It is useful for especially for production of steel and steel plates and pipes and all manufacturing purpose especially we are using there. Mostly all are metals only. These metals and all where you are using means steel pipes and as well as here plates and all manufacturing purpose and alloy for steels and all we are using there. And these lanthanide series also acting like on used as your mesh metals. Mesh metals is nothing but it is a mixture of here. There are other metals, lanthanide metal and iron metals also presenting there. So a mixture of your lanthanide metals and iron and some other small quantities of some other metals, some other elements also presenting there. So the composition is called as mish metals. We call as mish metals like that. We are calling there. So mish metal is nothing but lanthanoid metal plus along with iron metal is presenting there, and a small quantity of some other elements is presenting. So this composition is called as mish metals like that. We are calling there. So this mish metals, now where you are using means, especially we are using for the bullets. Bullets and the manufacturing purpose, shells and the manufacturing purpose, lighter flints and the manufacturing purpose. These mish metals and all especially we are using there. Right. Mixed oxides of lanthanides are employed as a catalyst in the petroleum cracking. So petroleum cracking is nothing but heavier substances we can easily converting into lighter substances. For example, larger molecule is there. This larger molecule, if you are applying your cracking process, you are applying cracking. So heavier molecule and all, if you are applying, you are converting into lighter molecules like that. Lighter molecule, nama divide pandrathu. So this process, what you call me cracking. So petroleum cracking and all, especially this mish metals and all, we are using there, right? And lanthanum oxides and all, where you are using lanthanum oxide, used for lanthanum oxide, where you are using means here phosphors in television screens and all, we are using there, as well as fluorescing surfacing and all, we are using there, right? Fluorescing surfaces as well as television screens, like a picture tube is there. So that picture tubes and all, we are using this phosphorus and all, especially we are using there. Lanthanide oxides, especially we are using in the television screens and fluorescing surfaces and all, we are using there. So this is about here lanthanide series elements. So tomorrow class, we are going to seeing that actinide series and all, a small concept will be left. That one tomorrow class, we are going to seeing that. Right. So thank you very much. So tomorrow we'll meet you once again. If you have any concerns you are having me, kindly inform to me. Right. So thank you. Have a nice day to all. Thank you all.